Well, it's 1:40 in the morning, and now I would like to just switch gears for a moment and do a tribute. Throughout the rest of the show, I'm going to play songs about electricity, songs about electronics, because at the top of the show, I mentioned that one of the greatest instructors and teachers at Hingham High School throughout the 60s, 70s, 80s, and 90s was Gordon Bates. And Gordon, his beautiful soul, went back to the world of eternal light just yesterday. And, you know, I had a handful of teachers in my life that really touched my soul and helped my life. And Mr. Bates was, I'd say, number one. I came into Hingham High as a freshman, and he was my physical science teacher. He taught me a lot of cool stuff, like, you know, about the displacement of water. I love that physical science trick. And all the different things. In fact, one time I did really well on a periodic table of elements test, and he was so excited and proud of me. And I was like, well, you must have had thousands of students who got into the periodic table. He goes, yeah, but not like you, man. You got into atomic weights. I'm like, yeah, hey, you know, I got into it. What can I say? But then, Mr. Bates, you know, you had that transition when you were a junior and a senior to what other science you would take. And Mr. Bates taught electronics. And I was like, well, of course I want to learn about electronics. And so, and I still use things Mr. Bates taught me from electronics every day. Just like if you're in the electrical field, Watt's Law and Ohm's Law and things about capacitance and resistance and transistors and everything that I learned, rheostats, all that stuff from Mr. Bates. And we had a screen printing class, and I took it upon myself to create a Mr. Bates t-shirt for when we graduated. And it had a bunch of great sayings that Mr. Bates used to say. You know, he'd want to get a reading, you know, like he'd want to know what your ohm meter reading was or your amp meter reading was. And he'd come up and he'd be like, all right, so what do you got going on here? He'd be like, oh, yeah. Oh, geez. Yeah. Oh, geez. That's a good reading right there. Oh, yeah. Yeah. You should have no problem with that. Yeah. You know, oh, these kits are old, he'd say. You know, if some of your capacitance or your resistance was off by a little. Oh, yeah. These kits are old. So he talked about the t-shirt that I made him. And then he used to, every once in a while, he'd call down to the office with a fake phone. And he used to just hold up his hand. And then one day I brought him in a fake phone to use as a prop. So he'd be like, oh, yeah, I got to call the office on this. And he'd pull out the fake phone. And then Mr. Bates was a funny guy. And what he used to do was if you were being a pain in his rear or a difficult student, he'd be like, all right, ladies and gentlemen, I want everybody to know who wins the Preparation H Award for the day. It'll be Patrick Ryan today. The Preparation H Award. And then finally, he had a prediction that I would go into the broadcasting world. He thought I'd be on Channel 4 as an anchorman. But no, here I am on 95.9 WATD and 1510 WMEX. And I brought up all that stuff because I have a clip of Mr. Bates talking all about that stuff. So let's listen to Gordon and all of his awesomeness being interviewed by Skylar Thaxter.
One of their outstanding teachers, and they said, be sure to go get Mr. Bates' reaction.
I feel honored, right?
A few words to the seniors?
Well, I wish them the very best, and I certainly have enjoyed the seniors I've had this year. They've been a great group of kids, especially in my E2 group.
Yeah,
they're outstanding.
The
that's probably, yeah, they're a very small group, so they're selective. See, that's
why.
They made a t-shirt.
The
right.
E2
t-shirt.
With your.
They also gave me an award, but I don't tell you what the award was.
What are your some of your favorite sayings that we have on the back of the shirt?
Oh, here? My favorite sayings. Gee whiz. And, you know, we'll phone that. And we have a little phone over here that we call in certain things. Right? When we get.
Watch the phone. See, this is a phone that we use during emergencies, see? And we have a direct line to Mr. McLeod. We have a direct line to the. We have a direct line to the National Education Association where we solve problems and things like that. So they probably mentioned that. And also we refer repeatedly to the teacher's manual. See, because the teacher's manual bails us out of a lot of difficult situations. So we have the phone, the teacher's manual and things like that.
Geez, you're not glad they're gone.
No, I'm sad they're gone. I really am.
But any special words for Pat Ryan?
Oh, Pat Ryan. Pat, hang in there, babe. He's all right. We're going to see him on Channel 4 in Boston one of these days, and he's going to be the anchor man, right?
Right. Right. That's right.
Absolutely. Good luck to you all.
Thank you very much.
Well, Mr. Bates, I hope I made you proud. I'm not an anchor man. I'm the love songs guy in the middle of the night. WATD's Venus Flytrap, Mr. Bates. Thank you for instilling awesomeness in my soul. I love you, man. Godspeed to the other side. Well, if you were learning in Mr. Bates' class, the one thing you'd be learning about would be...
Electricity.
When you're in the dark and you want to see, you need a...
Electricity.
Flip that switch and what do you get? You get a...
Electricity.
Every room can now be lit with just a...
Electricity.
Well, the one song that I came into class one day, and I said, Mr. Bates, you got to hear this song. It's so awesome. It was a little punk rock song from 1981 by the Polecats. Yeah, bust out your AC and DC current. Let's go. Yeah, beautiful song. You know it as the Electric Slide. Marsha Griffith's Electric Boogie. The Electric Slide. Some of us can still do it at weddings, right? Well, celebrating the life of Mr. Gordon W. Bates, my electronics teacher, but he was so much more, and he meant a lot to a lot of people, not just me. Everybody at Hingham High who ever had Mr. Bates knows that he was a stand-up, awesome guy. And Gordon graduated. He was an Abington guy. Grew up in Abington, lived in Abington his whole life, and graduated from Abington High in 1952. The man held 12 varsity letters in sports, including football. He was a football coach in Hingham. I believe it was in the 70s, Mr. Gordon Bates. And I figured we'd play some music from the spring that Gordon graduated high school. Two great songs I'll play before the end of the hour. Blue Tango by Leroy Anderson's band, and Wheel of Fortune by Kay Starr. So let's do Blue Tango first, in honor of the class of Abington High 1952, Gordon Bates included.
The South Shore's breaking news, weather, and traffic station.
WATD-FM Marshfield, WMEX Boston, and 95.9 WATD.com.
You're listening to Together on 95.9 WATD. Songs of love and dedication. Have a request? Dial 781-837-4900.
K-Star with Wheel of Fortune. The song was number one for 9 weeks in March of 1952. Well, March going into April and May. And then Blue Tango was number one for 5 weeks after that. Two songs from the spring of 1952, the year that Gordon Bates graduated high school. With his 12 varsity letters at the end of it, out of Abington High. And my deepest condolences go to Carrie, Gordon's wife, and Julie, his daughter as well, and the rest of the family. Gordon Bates touched my life and many other students at Hingham High's life. And whether it was his science courses, whether he was a coach, whether he was an electronics teacher, or a friend. If I can get through this story without crying. Man, when I was a kid, I'd get bullied, you know, and I had one major bully. One day the guy, this was back in the 90s when you could still wear a hat in school. It was like 89, 90 or whatever, and dude came by, took my hat off my head, and then, oh, of course, all day long, it's like the movie 3 O'Clock High. I'm like, oh, am I ever going to get my hat back? Is my bully going to beat me up? And I couldn't go to the principal, right? So, of course, I went to Gordon Bates, and I said, Mr. Bates, listen, I got this guy, he's a bully, he took my hat, and it perked Mr. Bates right up, being a football coach. You know, he's like, oh, really, huh? Someone's messing with you? Tell me more about it, huh? And he got all fired up about it. And I said, hey, listen, I don't want you to help me do anything except for when I go back later on today to go get my hat at the end of school, will you stand at the end of the hallway just to keep an eye on me so that just in case a fight does break out, I only get punched once before a teacher breaks it up. And he was like, yeah, no problem. That's the kind of guy Mr. Bates was. And I love you, Mr. Bates. Here's my last song in tribute. Here at the top of the second hour of Together with Patrick Ryan, Time Continuum, here on 95.9 WATD, the extended remix of the end theme to the movie Electric Dreams, because Mr. Bates was an unbelievable electronics teacher, and as my dear friend Josh Mitchell put it today, you know, electronics just became a pretty popular elective up in heaven. I've got you till 5 a.m. with beautiful gems like this. But you and I will always be together here in Electric Dreams. WATD.